Okay, correlations and causations footnotes. In the main video, I said that when you find a correlation, it's natural to look for explanations or causes of it. This is Reichenbach's principle. But sometimes correlations occur just by chance, like those on the website Spurious Correlations, which selectively cherry-picks data points from different stats that randomly happen to line up. As an example of a chance correlation, if I flip two coins enough times, eventually there'll be a long string of matching heads or tails just by chance. And if I just cherry-pick those flips, I can make it look like the two coins are super correlated. But when an apparent correlation is actually random in origin, like in this case, then if you keep looking at larger and larger samples, the correlation should go away. This is why it sometimes looks like particle physicists have discovered a new particle, only for that to go away when they collect more data. Also, you may have noticed there was no mention of feedback loops in the main video. That's because from a causal point of view, feedback loops, like how more grass means more sheep, means less grass means less sheep, means more grass, and so on, from a causal point of view, this isn't actually a loop. It's more of a chain where the amount of grass and sheep now affects the amount of grass and sheep next year, and the year after, and so on. So from year to year, there's feedback between the amount of grass and the amount of sheep, which we kind of draw as a loop, but the causal relationship always goes from the present to the future, which we should draw as some sort of spirally helix thing.